five young brothers from Gary, Indiana, have three number one records. Well, it's phenomenal. And that's exactly what they are. Ladies and gentlemen, my friends, the Jackson Five.
Yes. Plus one.
Okay. What's it going to be? Baby Light My Fire or Jam Up Jelly Tight or a Grooving on a Sunday Afternoon?
We'd rather do something you older guys can handle.
Thanks a lot. Like what?
How about shortening bread?
Shortening bread? Okay.
Yeah, you started, Mr. Neighbors.
Mama's little baby loves shortening, shortening. Mama's little baby loves shortening bread. Mama's little baby loves shortening, shortening. Mama's little baby loves shortening bread.
No, no, no. Not quite. We'll start it. You join us.
It's a necessity.
One time when we were a little short on cash, and our manager checked us into this hotel.
Here we are, sir. I think you'll find this room most comfortable.
Are you sure this is the cheapest room you got, man?
Please. Here at the Millard Fillmore, we only have luxury accommodation. In fact, when he's in town, George Wallace stays in this room.
Missing any sheets?
Well, well, well. I'm Curtis Snook, your bellhop.
Just put that over there.
Yes, sir.
Well, wait a minute. Well, what is this Jackson 5? Well, you registered under the name of Lester Brillstein.
Yeah, well, I am Lester Brillstein.
Well, then you must be Mr. 5. Howdy, Jackson.
Hey, yeah, that's it. He's Jackson 5, a young singer, and I'm his manager.
Oh, well, I'm certainly glad your name doesn't mean there are 5 members of a group, because we have a very strict rule in this hotel. Only 2 to a room.
Well, there's just 2 of us.
Good. there's one other thing I always tell show people. Try not to disturb the normal guests. I wonder if Connie Hilton has days like this.
Boy, you're just gonna love your stay right here at the Miller Fillmore. It's one of
the... We're in kind of a hurry, ma'am. Will you just put the trunk against the wall?
Yes, sir.
That's crazy. Do you have change for a dollar?
Oh, I sure do. Say here. 1, 2, 3, 4 quarters.
Thank you. And here's a dollar for your trouble.
Oh, no, sir. I couldn't accept money for just doing my job.
Whatever you say, man.
Oh, And if you need anything else, you just call on me. Curtis Snook's my name.
Right,
Curtis
right, Snook. Right, right. We'll remember that. Curtis? Snook.
Yes.
Snook. Yes, yeah, we'll remember that. Yeah. Sure glad we're not the King family. Are you sure you guys are gonna be all right for the audition?
Sure, but from being in there, we're all gonna sound like Wayne Newton.
Look, fellas, I'm sorry, but this way we save $40.
Hey, where's Marlon?
Quick, all right, back in the trunk. Just a second. Look, man, I don't mind traveling, but I hate the pack.
I forgot to bring your laundry bag. You know, you folks ought to do your laundry more often.
Yeah, well, we'll remember that. Do you have change for a dollar?
I sure do. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4 quarters.
Thank you. And here is a dollar for your trouble.
No. It's like I told you a while ago. I can't accept money for just doing the job.
What do you say, man? Snook, that is.
I'll remember.
Yes.
Are you sure Sammy Davis travels this way?
I'm starved.
Yeah, we're all starved. You not been in this truck for 2 days. I haven't had a thing in my mouth except Tito's elbow.
Look, how can you guys think of food when we got an audition coming? Now, come on, look, we got to rehearse. Let's go, man. 1, 2, 3. Quick, hide. Just a second.
I brought you some nice fresh linen. I'll make up your bed for you.
Oh, look, that ain't necessary.
Oh, it's no problem, no trouble at all. I bet you didn't even know where the bed was. It's the private thing that you find in the hotel room.
Yeah, well, you've been very helpful, but we're in kind of a hurry, and I need a little privacy so I can take a shower.
Bellhop Snook does everything he orders. From making up the bed to turning on the water.
No, don't turn on the water.
That ought to be just right.
Oh, it's too hot.
What was that?
That's an old trick of mine. I used to be a ventriloquist.
Oh, all eyes. Hey, that was just wonderful. Can you make your voice, can you make your voice come out of that closet?
Oh, well, I don't think so.
Oh, yes, you can.
God!
Yeah.
Boy, that was terrific.
Yeah, well, look, I'll do some more for you sometime. But right now, I really got to grab that shower.
I didn't even see your lips move. How you do that?
Well, it's kind of an old trick. It's a professional secret. Well, the guy's secret. Come on. Let's go. Got some real rehearsing to do. Come on, let's go. I want you. Wait, hide. Just a second.
Here we are, the Millard Fillmore complimentary lunch.
Well, it's very nice of you, but I really don't have time.
But Mr. Five here has to eat. These are his wonder years.
Then I wonder if I can have a chicken sandwich.
One chicken sandwich coming up.
And I'll have a two-in tomato.
Holy, Miss Brillstein, you are some kind of ventriloquist. We don't have no tuner, but would a turkey be all right?
Could I?
Well, you just go ahead and eat your sandwich, Mr. Five, and you'll grow up to be just as big and tall as I am. Some shortening bread.
Come on.
get with the food. Will you just leave us alone, please?
Huh? Well, whatever you say, Mr. Brillstein. Who's dying?
Well, what do you know? It's my ventriloquist dummy.
You know, he looks just like you do when you was a boy. Can you get him to say anything?
Well, just one sentence, then you have to leave.
Okay.
How are you, Michael?
Very hungry.
Golly, I don't see how you do it.
Want to see another trick?
Yeah, sure would.
I can eat a ham sandwich while Mr. Brillstein sings a song.
Hey, I like that. Go ahead.
Away down upon the Swanee River, far, far away. Okay, that's the end of that. Goodbye.
How about another course?
Oh, I love that. Go ahead.
I got a better trick. How would you like to hear me do 5 voices at once?
5 voices at once? Well, sure.
Of course, you understand. This is just a rehearsal.
All right, that's all right. Go ahead.
Well, we're going to do Camp Town Races on a count of 4. Now, you watch my lips very closely. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
Camp Town ladies, sing this song.
Do-da, do-da.
Mr. Calalini, this is the world's greatest ventriloquist, and this here's his dummy.
Ha!
He can make horses come out of here, and out of here, and out of here, all at one time. All right, out! Out! You out of the trunk! You two, out! And you two, out!
Wait a minute! You're lucky. We could have been the Mormon Tabernacle Choir.
I'm sorry, Mr. Brillstein. I don't know why Mr. Calalini's acting this way.
You're sorry? Don't you understand what's been going on in here?
Well, there is one thing that I don't understand. How can a ventriloquist talk while his dummy's got a sandwich in his mouth?
Oh, well, that's very simple, young man. Very, very simple. Just like this. I'll be glad when you're dead, you rascal, you. I'll be glad when you're dead, you rascal, you.
I find myself in times of trouble. My